welcome to the first episode of A&R Black Hat's Dirty Laundry, where you're going to get an insight into how all of us here on the Black Hats build our Jank Monster decks and the arduous, often alcohol-filled process involved in making our Netrunner decks. So, Kyle, otherwise known as it just got Riel, is having some technical difficulties, but I'm sure none of you will be upset to see that Chase, otherwise known as Sly Squid, is joining us.
Hi, everybody.
So, for tonight's episode, I thought it would be a good place for us to start by doing something that's starting to become popular in the meta again, and that is a tag punishment deck. I feel like with the Fear of Clot, tag punishment is something that's coming back, and we're actually starting to see more of an NBN that's balanced with those fast advance elements, but not depending on them for victory. What do you think,
but
Chase?
When you say tag punishment, you also mean NBN tag punishment, right?
Yeah, we're deciding not to go with Blue Sun in this case, because the tag punishment in green decks is pretty clear, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's called I find out where your house is, and then I blow it up. Whereas NBN has a lot more flexibility in what it can do with tags. So when Kyle and I were discussing doing this segment, we wanted to discuss something that people have kind of touched the surface on, but not put a ton of work into, which is NBN tag punishment.
All right.
Yeah, I mean, I think it's pretty exciting.
I'm so excited.
You look excited.
I'm uncontaining, like I can't even contain my excitement right now.
I mean, you look pretty excited. Chase is joining us.
I'm haggard and tired. I'm
yeah,
at work right now.
In the break room at work. Oh, you don't live there? You don't just have those like in your living room of your like apartment?
Oh yeah, that's what I do. I go out and I buy my own snacks
and then painstakingly put them in. Yeah. All right. So one of the biggest things that is going to be a feature of this segment is we want to make sure that, you know, as we're doing this, you know, people, if we have anybody, you know, who wants to ask a question about why we're including a certain card or why we're doing certain things, we want to make sure that you have the opportunity to, you know, ask us a question and let us know, you know, what you want to know about. So,
and also with that too, anybody who questions anything, make sure, are we putting this onto YouTube after?
We will.
So leave
a comment.
Any comments down in the comment area, because a lot of these, after a certain amount of time, can be revisited. So like this tag punishment idea can be revisited in, you know, a few weeks, assuming something comes out. I mean, this game changes on a month-to-month basis, right?
Yes. So, it's like a drug that just keeps getting re-engineered to be more addictive.
I know, and I saw some of the spoilers and
yeah,
some of the write-up spoilers.
It's like,
childlike.
It's, I like how when the tech spoilers come out, we're always like, this can't possibly be real. There's no way that this card's real.
And then it is.
It's
just real.
Yeah. So first things first, we have to pick an identity. We're not going to play with imaginary identities, so we're not going to use Harpsichord Studios. Though I will comment that I think that Harpsichord has a unique ability to do mid-season's minimal ice tag punishment in a way that a lot of other NBN can't, because you can say, you know what, that's fine, just dig me for 8 cards with medium, I really don't care.
Yeah.
So that really leaves us with the 3 NBN identities that are left. You know, NBN is the only faction that hasn't had a big box yet, so they have the least number of identities. So we have Making News, which is the 4515, 2 credits for tagging. We have The World is Yours, which people have, like, more or less forgotten about. And we have Near Earth Hub. So I guess where we should probably start is, where do we go with an identity? You know, how do you identify which one of the 2 primary NBN identities, Making News or Near Earth Hub?
This is the one type of deck that I think you build the deck and then you pick the ID to go with it. Because, like, I mean, if our deck ends up being more asset based, then I say we go with Near Earth Hub. if it's more trace based, we go with making news. If we want it to be fast, then I think we go with The World Is Yours.
Right. I feel like if you're trying to go for a kill sometimes, The World Is Yours can be good because, yeah, the Scorched are all of your influence, but you're going to find them a lot faster if you're running a 40-card deck.
Your agenda density is going to be, well, could be lower. I guess it's not going to be lower because...
Right. But you're going to either win or lose much faster. How's that?
Yeah.
Either way, the outcome will be quick. All right, so let's just start with making news because it has the universal basic 4515. And if we want to switch out for Near Earth Hub, we'll switch to that later.
Yeah.
So I guess if we're going to start making an NBN deck, we should probably just start with three Astroscript pilot programs. Let's just go ahead and put those in there. Yeah, let's just go ahead and get those in there. So my question to you then is if we're making a tag punishment deck, how do we fill out the rest of the agenda suite? We should probably get the other three too, because there's never reasons to not really take your three twos.
We definitely want to...
We definitely want Beals and Astroscripts, I would say.
Yeah, Beals and Astroscripts, and I'd say that I think we want pretty much the standard NBN agenda suite with
so what NAPDs as well.
Yeah, and breaking news.
See, okay, not you don't want TGBT or yeah TGTBT.
It depends on where we're going, right? So like making news, you can be proactive as opposed to reactive, right?
Okay.
So, like if we're doing an install heavy deck, then we can install it and kind of leave it as a trap, advance, score, and then do whatever our tag punishment thing is, right? So if we really want to close accounts or we really want to get rid of a Katie,
right,
we have that ability kind of on the fly as opposed to relying on them accessing. And I don't know. I like being proactive, especially as the corp, because I find it's too easy to get into... like this rhythm where you're being dictated on where to go by the runner, right?
That's fair. We'll do two breaking news for now, and we'll see if, based on what we have, we want to change it out. So I think rather than I'm going to put in three Jacksons. I'm going to put in three hedge funds, and then I'm going to leave everything else alone for now. I think if you're going to do a tag punishment deck, I think one of the first questions you need to address is what type of tag punishment are we doing? Are we doing destroy your life? Or are we going for a kill? Are we going for some combination of, you know, psycho and tag punishment? What are we doing, right? I'll pose this to you now. You know, with the number of genetics and all the resources that runners are running right now, do you think that Freelancer is finally worth a slot in a deck?
I was thinking Freelancer, and I mean, even just a two of might be really nice.
Because I've been finding, me personally, lately with a lot of the noise decks and a lot of the genetics-based decks that I've been coming up against lately, I wish I had, like, one extra click and, like, two extra credits to take out like the Katie Jones and the something else. Do you know what
I'm
saying?
I can speak to that because I really leverage with my max deck. I really leverage having like a liberated account sitting at four credits and my Joshua B sitting there. And I'm comfortable leaving those out because the goal is to keep your economy low and to force reses and that stuff. So I get into this like false sense of security where I'm like, okay, well, he doesn't have the resources, even though I'm going tag punish, like I'm going tag me. He doesn't have the resources to really deal with these two things, and I'm going to let the game run away, right? I know with liberated account for me, that's kind of my counter. It's a very soft counter to closed accounts because I feel like, okay, your economy is going to be really low. You're going to spend money to close accounts me. And then you're going to have to get rid of my liberated account, too. If you're willing to do that much, then that basically is going to set us back the same, right? So
somebody
I know personally, that whole long spiel was personally, I think I would fear freelancer. If it was played like as a steady thing, it would make me rethink what I'm doing.
Okay. So somebody just suggested Shoot the Moon, which I think is definitely a good choice, at least as a one of.
See, now, I mean, like, so we have a couple options, right, when it goes to picking our type, right? Nearpad is done. I mean, we could sit here and rebuild a Nearpad deck, but that deck is built. So right out of the gate, we're just not going to use dedicated response teams, right?
No.
Are we agreed on that?
Yeah, absolutely.
So now, Scorch decks exist. That's the Butcher Shop deck, right?
Right.
I don't feel like we should make a Butcher Shop deck. So maybe we go for a straight, like, taxing NBN that has, like, almost like a Glacier style, and go for a Shoot the Moon, like a mid-season Shoot the Moon.
Yeah.
Try to pull that off as humanly, like, as fast as humanly possible.
I think that's a great idea, and I think Gutenberg is a fantastic ice to go with Shoot the Moon.
Oh yeah, definitely.
Yeah, let me just go ahead and res that for free, and you get to deal with it for the rest of the game. Okay, thanks. All right, so we got one of Shoot the Moon, two freelancers, three hedge funds. What else? I guess we got to put in two. I would put in a two of closed accounts, just because that card just brutalizes people. What else? Well, we
want sweeps week.
Yeah.
For sure.
Two of mid seasons. Probably don't need three because we're gonna have other ways to apply tags.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm trying to think what else. Manhunt maybe?
The thing is,
Or do we just want our traces to be on ice?
We're getting really into that gray area where it's more about, like, we don't want to get there where we're just putting in all of the tag cards, right? We want, like, we also have to be able to score out with this too, right? So, I mean, everybody knows an early Astro script can change the game, right? So we want to have some solid way to just, like, burst out agendas if we can, right? So we don't want to just put, like, 3/4 of our deck towards tagging.
Okay.
So I think if we get, I mean, between Gutenberg and Data Raven, I think
we're gonna be in good shape.
We're good, yeah.
Like, I think
Data Raven can almost, it's like a soft end the run, right?
Right. I think two psychographics also plays into what we're doing really well.
Yeah, for sure.
All right. So right now we have 15 operations so far.
See, that's a lot.
Yes, it is. We have three hedge funds, three sweeps weeks, one Shoot the Moon, two psychographics, two mid-season replacements, two freelancers, two closed accounts.
Okay. I feel like, okay, let's move on from
and then we'll cut
now.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's how I always, for anybody who wants a little insight to me, like when I have this idea, like this overarching idea, I take a bell and I'm like, okay, well, I want to make an RP deck that taxes. So I just, on my table, I just root through all of my Gentechi cards and just throw at anything that I feel has a little bit of a tax, and then I trim from there, right? So you might find these combos, if you just throw everything at the deck at first, you might find these combos that you didn't see as you're trimming and you're really thinking about the deck you want to build. I won't be part of that, but I could be part of this whole, let's throw a bunch of cards at it and let you and Kyle figure it out.
Whoa.
Done my break.
Hang on one second. Sorry about that. We just had a little blip.
Oh, that's okay.
Yeah, I mean, I agree with you. I think we should go to ice next, because ice is going to be the other big ticket that we need to make sure that we fill out before we do anything else.
I agree. So I feel like basics that are just never going to be bad are would be like just right off the bat, start with 3 pop-up windows, 3 wraparounds, and 3 toll booths, or 2 toll booths. I think that's like NBN's bread and butter right there.
Yeah, I hear that wraparound's really good.
Yeah, a little bit.
I hear. Now, it's important to note that we also haven't spent any influence at this point.
So, influence is kind of a different beast. I don't think because we have a clear goal yet that we need to avidly try to spend influence. Like, we're not going, okay, we want a Scorch deck in NBN, so we know where our influence is. We don't know where our influence is, so we can continue to build the deck and then trade cards out that would do something better in another out of another faction, right?
Yeah.
So, like, maybe we use celebrity gifts instead of, you know, I know it's blasphemy, but hedge funds, right? Like, maybe that's where we're at.
Can we talk about how good of a card Gutenberg is?
Yeah, Gutenberg is...
It's so good.
So dirty.
Alright, we're going to put 2 of those in, because that card is great. I think
3 Gutenberg.
Really? That many? They only get boosted up strength for being on R&D.
What are they...
Their base strength is 3. Go up to 6 if they're on R&D.
Are you planning on running 3 Data Ravens?
Yes, because they're more portable.
Okay, so 3 Data Ravens and 2 Gutenbergs.
2 Gutenbergs, those are our sentries. And then with the toll booths and the pop-up windows, we have 5 code gates. So we're currently at 13 ice.
Yeah.
Which isn't necessarily the end of the world in
well,
a tagging
remember,
deck.
We're planning on going Glacier, right?
Right.
So we are looking to get, what, 18 ice for a Glacier deck? I run ice light. So maybe I'm wrong on that. You guys can correct in the comments.
Well, you're not light ice light. You play Jinteki that doesn't really need ice.
I've run decks with 6 ice before, so.
Yeah, but that's because you play those weird red cards.
Good red cards. You're mispronouncing good.
Yeah, I'm mispronouncing. I must be using an archaic pronunciation. So what else can we put in here? Like, if we're building Glacier.
See, this is where we can get a little bit of our influence out of.
Somebody's mentioning Vipers, which does synergize somewhat. Oh, hi Zero Man, my Netrunner DB friend on our stream here. Caduceus could be good, Hunter could be good, Shadow could be good.
Yeah, see, I'm liking that. Caduceus would be good, but the balance of me says let's find a barrier now.
Yeah, he also mentioned 2 TMIs for barriers.
I like TMI. I know that a lot of people like TMI, but I
agree. TMI is good if you're playing Breaking News. It's great.
What does TMI do with Shoot the Moon? Does it just rez?
No, because it says when you res it, run the trace. So I imagine if you shot the moon with it, you would still have to do the trace. Because it doesn't say as an additional cost. It just says when you res TMI.
Yeah. Is there a barrier that tags?
I don't think there is.
Yeah, I don't think there is either.
Yeah. Yeah, alright, let's widen open our search here, as far as ice is concerned. What could be interesting? I mean, Caduceus is definitely...
Caduceus is good, but now we're running around with...
Like 8 sentries.
Like a lot of sentries.
Viper's also so good.
Good.
I hear people are pretty interested in Mimic nowadays, that Architect is a thing. I hear that's a problem. What is Viper? Viper only splashes for one? How does an ice that good only splash for one influence? That's a really good card for making news. Yeah, let's go ahead and put two of those in there. Do we want to, just for the lulz, put in a one of Shinobi?
I don't know. No, let's not do that. We're trying to build good decks, right, Dan?
Yeah. I mean, but you can treat it like the when it works, you res it, the rest of the time you don't.
I know, between me and you, and I hope that when I play this deck, I run into one Shinobi and flatline, like when we're playing one, but I don't think we should share the world. That
piece.
Yeah. Let them figure it out themselves.
Because I'm just like, well, I'm making news, so, you know, we could do that. God, I'm trying to think what else, like, what else we could reasonably put in here. That the problem with NBN is that their ice is porous, but it's still really good, and a lot of the stuff that we could import is contrary to what NBN wants to do.
Yeah. I am going to have to let you go.
All right, good, because Kyle just logged on.
That's perfect.
That's okay, perfect.
So, everybody, hello from Kodiak Boots, and you guys have a good night.
See you, Chase.
Yeah, later, buddy.
All right. Give me one moment, everybody. We're going to get Kyle in here. With this lovely avatar picture. Kyle, you there?
Hello, I am here.
Hey, so we're building this crazy monster of a deck here. Yeah. I had a feeling I would see you here, Zero Hour. Alright, so, what I'm gonna do, Kyle, is I'm gonna screen share with you so you can see what I'm doing.
Okay, perfect.
So that way you don't have to look at the stream. And then I need you to start up your camera.
Perfect.
So, can you see my screen?
Yeah, I've got everything.
Okay. So, what we're basically working with thus far is we decided to go with Making News to start. And we've built a deck that really doesn't need a lot of influence thus far, and we got to the point where we're building ice. A couple of the discussion pieces is we discussed that Freelancer might finally be good because of all the chronotype and various resource-based goodness that's come out in the last few packs.
Oh, yeah.
Closed accounts, two mid-seasons, two psychographics, one shoot the moon, three sweeps weeks, three hedge funds.
Okay.
And then we got the three J Howls and then standard NBN suite. So what do you think?
Oh, well, if we're going with the shoot the moon, then I think we need to go with more ice than just a couple of toll booths. I mean, Gutenbergs are basically free to res. Data Ravens are going to be situational. We'll res them sometimes, but they turn off once a runner goes tag me.
Right.
So without real hard punishment, you know, a runner can really take some damage. They can take tag punishment, and if you're porous, they could still just top deck for the win. And that's usually what happens. Once you mid-season someone, you have to have ice on R&D. That will keep them from just running. So I think Archers, Flare as a one of is okay. I've experimented with it off and on. The fact that it ends the run is nice, but...
So, Archers, we're just saying if we can res them, great. If not, that's good too.
Right. And plus, you know, you have Breaking News in faction, so in a pinch, you don't have the combo cards, you need something to land. If you can wreck the runner's rig, it buys you time.
Right. What else? I'm trying to think what else we could put in that's really big. That's worth having in. You know, that isn't going to be like a a hindrance to us. Do you know what I'm saying?
Right. Information overload is pretty good. It is six to res. You know, need to have 10 cost ice in order to really benefit from shoot the moon.
I think one information overload is the right number.
Yeah. I was doing two, and two data ravens, and then also playing sub boost, as silly as that sounds, because post closed account or post tag me, it's a nice way to turn those ice back on.
That's an interesting. We just got a comment. Susano no Mikoto could be really potent as a shoot the moon res. You there?
Yeah, sorry. If you hear any loud noises, it's me trying to get this camera to stand up straight.
Okay. Yeah. Are there any barriers that do anything really interesting?
Wall of Thorns and Marcus, maybe?
Yeah, Wall of Thorns could be interesting.
It's only one influence.
Is
pretty high cost curve, though.
Yeah. That's really silly. Yeah, because basically what Chase said right before he left was basically that we have to be able to leverage our advantage and, you know, get tags on and get them to that point where they're going to say screw it.
Right.
Because that's when we have more control.
Yeah, and with the taxing ice and the making news credits, Ash is not bad either.
Yeah, no, that's another thing that was in there. Yeah, we could put in a two of Ash. That could probably be pretty strong. Yeah. I was also
be on the fence about that.
Say that again?
I was going to say I might also be on the fence about pop-up window, simply because if they know you're going to be running Tag Me, they're maybe less likely to run as often.
Okay.
So it might be better to have tag punishment or binary?
Yeah, I mean, that's fair. What's that, one of flare. We're going super heavy on sentries in this deck so far. There you go.
There we go, I'm live. You can see my awesome headset.
Yeah, I mean, we both have our super futuristic headsets, man.
Heck yes.
So yeah, welcome Kyle to Dirty Laundry.
Thank you.
Yeah. So, I don't know. I think we've got to fill out our influence, but I think we've also might have a slight money issue for the early game that we need to address as well. Are you also on the stream?
I am not. I am looking to fire it up.
All right, yeah, get it fired up so you can see the questions as well.
Perfect.
Yeah, I mean, we could put in red herrings. As I think red herrings, we're really fighting for deck slots here.
Yeah, that's the big thing. There's so many great punishment cards, and sometimes it's ratios and also just effectiveness.
Yeah, I mean, we haven't made any cuts yet, but just with, like, generic stuff that we wanted to put in, we ended up with 15 operations.
Yeah.
And we haven't even really gotten fancy with it. We're just got, like, some of the basics. That's one of the things that I think constrains this archetype somewhat. Is that it's hard to fit everything that you want from a punishment perspective into this deck and still have room for the deck to be functional.
Yes, exactly. You'll have a whole hand of things that you need them to be tagged in order to fire, and then you're just waiting for them to fall into the trap.
Right.
So, if I can say, I think that splitting tag punishment into groups, you know, economic control, rig destruction, etc., will really help you to slim down the numbers. You know, a freelancer is click and credit efficient when they're tagged if they're playing resources, but oftentimes, if it's an impactful resource, if they're tagged, they're not going to load a KD. If they know you have the money to trash it if they were to,
Or right.
If you're poor, they'll load it anyway and make you, you know, deny yourself, denying them.
No, but I think now the resource game is so important to so many of the different runner archetypes we see right now, with the exception of maybe prepaid Kate. Everybody else is running at least one critical resource.
Yeah, especially with the Glacier game, yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. So, I don't know. So, right now we've got 15 ice, we have 2 TMIs, 2 wraparounds, 2 toll booths, 2 Vipers, 2 Archers, 2 Data Ravens, 2 Gutenbergs, and 1 Information Overload. So, what else do we need to add?
Troll. You need to add on-effect pieces of ice. Things that cause punishment regardless of breakers, unless someone were to defend them.
Okay. And let's be honest, if we run 2 trolls in this deck and somebody fems it, actually you can't even fem it because it's an... You can't buy... Would it just pay zero? Would they just pay zero to bypass?
Zero counts as breaking all, yeah.
That's weird, but I mean, that's still a moral victory for us if they pay 9. All right, so we're still at 10 influence. How do we deal with that?
I think Zero Hour has a good idea in the stream, because when you're not Near Earth Hub, we kind of get spoiled being used to Near Earth Hub for so long, having such insane draw. But we don't have that ability anymore, so I think the GLC is a good idea. Cards like that, you know, between anonymous tip or if we're looking to spend influence, green level clearance, you know, giving us credits, giving us cards, especially a deck that's inherently kind of combo reliance. You're going to see lots of various pieces, but without business show, which we can't really protect as well in this deck, or burst econ in anonymous tip and green level clearance. It's going to be hard to get what we need when we need it.
I think that's fair. Can you see everything that's in the deck right now?
Let me make sure I'm in the right window. Yes.
So, I think we need to, you know, we need to make 2 cuts somewhere.
I see. Okay. Let's see, is there a good...
Yeah, I mean, do we need... do we need...
Psychographics, that's the big question.
Do we need 2 psychographics?
When you don't have it, you're going to wish that you had it. And then when you have both of them in your hand, you're going to be annoyed that they're in there. That's just the nature of a combo deck.
Yeah.
We could cut... We could, in theory, at least cut 1 ice. We have 2 Data Raven and 2 Gutenberg. Let's see.
I already went down to 1 Freelancer.
Yeah. I think between the Gutenbergs and the Data Ravens, that something could be cut there. I think, unless you're playing sub-boost, that Gutenberg is a superior Data Raven, since you really put it on a central to just ward them off until you can get taxing ice on a remote.
Okay, so what, we're dropping a Data Raven?
If we drop both of them, that puts us at 49, yeah.
Ooh. And then that puts us at 15, only 15 ice, though.
Yeah, that's true. That is true. 18 operations, wow. We should definitely drop from those slots first.
Yeah. Let's see. Well, we've got some money now. We got lots of money, which is going to be important for this deck.
Right. Let's see. Utility options like Archive Memories to get Ash back, or to get... Actually, that's a great idea. Combo decks love Archive Memories. I'm looking for ways to manipulate the influence.
So if we cut a blue level...
Yeah.
And let's say let's cut one of the psychos. so we could pitch it and get it back later.
Okay. And if that's the case, what happens when we land in mid-season beyond the closed accounts? We've got that we can draw from. Freelancer is still fairly situational, depending, but Shoot the Moon is great. We have One Psycho, which is a great way to leverage our tags into a win, which is what it's all about. And then we have an information overload as far as cards that make an impact. So we have three cards in a 49-card deck that will capitalize from them just going tag me.
Right. So what's Archive? Is Archive just one? I'm pretty sure it's one.
It's two.
I mean, that works.
Yeah.
And then I guess we could just...
I don't want to drop so much ice. I'd like to... 16 ice seems like it could be okay.
All right, I'm cutting...
Especially for a combo-y deck.
I'm cutting one sweeps week.
Oh, no, don't do that. Money's where it's at. Keep the sweeps week. Maybe drop a Data Raven and Freelancer and go up to two Psycho.
You mean drop both Freelancers?
Yeah, maybe try...
You're breaking my heart.
I know, but, you know, it's the trap of the type of the deck, is that every card is great, but which one is more great? You know, especially given that prepaid Kate is so big, you could hit her Proko, or you could just deny her 30 credits by tagging her in closed accounts.
That's true. All right, so let's do that.
Yeah, this looks like a pretty good list to start with.
Yeah. Do we just want to see how this works?
Yeah, I like this list.
Yeah, I mean, I think it looks pretty damn good. All right. So let me go ahead and... All right, internet, you guys are now going to get a view into... look at those slots, everybody. 690 slots.
What am I sitting at?
Yeah, pay no attention to the fact that 516 of them are filled with utter garbage.
156 of 338 for me, but it's all top tier.
Oh, yeah, everything you build is top tier, right?
Yep.
All right, so let's go ahead and find us a game. All right, everybody who's watching, once I actually jump into a game, I will add it to the stream once that it's loaded up. Oh yeah, looking for runner.
We could just join a Penis Lands game. That sounds...
Yeah, that looks... That looks good. Yeah.
Right?
I actually had somebody the other day ask me if I was actually Code Marvelous or not, because I had Code Marvelous on Octagon. I was like, yes, you're right. You've uncovered my evil plan to steal somebody's Netrunner fame.
Didn't you have someone do that to you with one of your Gravedigger decks?
Well, yeah. Somebody posted my deck and then even links to our video, but then just posted my deck list before I could. And I'm like, thanks for being a friend, man. Like, right. All right. Somebody join the game. All right. All right. Yes, yes, message of the day. All right. Give me 1 second, everybody. I'm going to go ahead and get us all set up. All right.
There, I finally see your game posted.
No, I got it. Oh, are you for real right now? I'm getting the picture-in-picture for everything going on.
Oh, yeah. Webception?
Yeah, hang on.
What? It must be maybe a minute and a half ago. That was the most outlandish way to get a cat off of your lap that I've ever seen.
Yeah, well, you know.
Oh my gosh.
That's Balder. He is probably the world's worst cat. Alright. Hopefully I can't look at the stream now without having everything freak out.
Okay.
So, hopefully, people can just see the board. Can you check the stream and see what people can see?
Yeah, sure. I'm checking it now. Well, we're doing some delay catch up here. I'll wait to see. And if you guys watching the stream, can I get a text thumbs up or something like that? If everything looks normal to you guys. So what is your mulligan?
A hand with not good stuff. Hopefully the stream looks okay. Let me get rid of.
Okay, yeah, it's the window is small, but it looks okay.
Okay, hang on, let me fix that. All right, should be good now. I just can't bring up the broadcast, or otherwise it creates the window in window forever thing.
Okay.
All right. All right. So we've got a data raven, a troll. I'm going to sweep click one, because why not? We're up against Haley, so I think Data Raven on R&D, and then the Troll on HQ.
Because
we're already we're already holding a mid-season. If he picks that Beale out of HQ, okay. We don't really care.
Okay, yeah, because as a shaper, they're just going to hit the Data Raven and go, okay, got it, don't run that on my last click. And then they're going to makers you and then drop the tag.
Right, which
so
is cool.
Need to have economic superiority, right?
All right, I'm trusting you to keep an eye on the online questions. Yeah. So my cat here, Balder, he's the most dog-like cat I've ever had. He just wants to be in my lap literally all of the time.
Oh boy. So with Opus and SMC, you think this is a big breakers deck? Instead of stealth?
I don't know. So now we've got a Project Beale, a Breaking News, a Jackson Howard, and a midseason. I think we drop the Jackson draw once and see what happens.
Can you share a hand with me?
Yeah, visibility. Are you in? Are you in our game?
Oh, I'm in as a spectator, so you probably can't share hand, can you?
No.
Okay.
I should be still screen sharing with you on Skype, though.
This is true. I get my windows up. There we go. That's better.
Yeah, I think we Jackson one time. See what we draw. Another sweeps week and a hedge fund.
Oh, yeah, that's looking really good.
And then I hedged last click.
Yeah, she's going to be likely to draw left this turn, so holding the sweep was the right call. Because we'll get more out of it this next turn. Or maybe not, okay.
Running that HQ, let's res that troll.
And so maybe they'll lose a click, go on in and take an agenda, and then you can sweeps mid-season, and there we go.
Yeah, it seems good.
See, I think that's fair, because it's one res cost, and there you go. Pays a click, access last click.
Yeah, I'm
first
okay.
First golden rule of Netrunner, don't do this, ladies and gentlemen.
Well, but he had no idea it was there. I mean, I guess he could have jacked out.
Right. What did he see? Sweeps?
Yep.
Okay.
Alright, so now we've got an archer.
Alright, so that means the breaking news is looking pretty good as a score while we're waiting for them to take the Beal, right?
Yeah, so let's just go ahead and do that.
But we've got to wait for that SMC to be off the table if we're going to assume sharpshooter.
Yeah.
That's really going to make it lose its effect.
Absolutely. I mean, one of the main reasons I wanted to do this as Tag Me is we're basically building my deck for regionals right now. I already know what my runner deck's going to be. My noise deck is going bananas. All right, so we res the Data Raven. Do you jack out or do you continue? I think we might get an SMC pop if he's got something interesting. If it's Big Rig, we might see the...
Rejected.
Oh, nope. I was going to say maybe we'll see the Femme come out right here.
Yeah, jacking out is the right call there because one take eight turn puts us on the back foot now.
All right.
The Data Raven telegraphs that it's a Tag Me deck.
All right, so now we're
making news didn't.
Now we've got an Astro.
Two agendas. Well, you have the archer, but with all that money, I mean, you res the archer, they sharpshooter it, they're still ahead 10 credits.
Yeah.
You might need to Jackson pitch this and try for a reset or just go credit sweeps. And I mean, but credit sweeps is going to telegraph so much.
He's only got three cards. That's my concern.
Yeah.
So I just Jackson one time, we pulled a closed account and an Ash.
Okay, that's great. I would definitely pitch the Beal out of that, maybe even the Astro, because we've got the beginnings of a remote setup.
Yeah.
That Data Raven's definitely going to keep him out until he's ready.
Yeah, well, this is actually a good test for this deck, because Mopus Academy is going to be this deck's biggest enemy.
Right. That's the great thing about NBN, though, is you don't need to be ahead of them in credits like with Wayland. To hit them with a tag and a closed accounts. And
right.
If they take eight twice, you just deny them, two full turns.
It is stealth.
There we go.
A Cyber Solutions and a silencer just went down.
Yeah. So definitely Switchblade and Refractor.
Alright, we just picked up a Data Raven. Do we start building a scoring server with the Data Raven and an Ash behind it?
Yeah. We can definitely assume Switchblade and not Femme. So Archer on the remote with an Ash. We need to wait for them to be tagging for that Archer to fire. So this is kind of a treacherous place to be just because they have so much money. Best thing to do is to try to bait them into a run. Even if we lose an agenda early and try to not lose an Astro, bait them into a run, make them use some tricks so they don't just sit out with that control card on the table, the SMC.
Right. So I think I want to put down the Data Raven with the Ash and bluff it like an Astro script I'm trying to rush.
Yeah. Fire the Jackson and then put the Ash down alone. But if she just trashes the Ash, that's pretty bad for us.
No, I mean Data Raven with the Ash under it.
Oh, okay.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah, but if it baits a run and they take the tag, they access the Ash and trash it.
Yeah, I don't know.
That's what the Ash is in there for, is to actually protect the cards we want to protect. Unless we can get an NAPD, then that turns on the midseason. That's a really good play.
Yeah. So I just Jacksoned once. We picked up another Jackson and a mid-season replacement.
Okay.
I'm going to get the Archer on the table and not put anything behind it yet. And then I'm going to sweeps last click. And then we only need one copy of mid-season replacement, so I'm going to trash the second copy.
Right. So icing the remote should be telling him to look for HQ.
That was the idea. If I can get him to waste a couple runs on HQ.
Right.
What is that beeping? All right, he's running archives, so I'm going to pull everything out.
So it might be a second click maker's eye, take the tag.
So I'm pulling back both, and then I'm bringing back the sweeps week.
Yeah.
We're getting like a weird beeping from your headset.
From mine?
Yeah, like a little bit of feedback or something.
Oh, there's a ceiling fan up above me. Maybe that's what it is. I don't, I mean, probably not, but maybe.
You really think he's running Maker's Eyes? Oh, here comes the wasted legwork. He does realize, oh, there it is.
So I think that was worth it for a troll. Like, I mean, he's down to 6 credits.
Yeah, and it didn't even matter
and
because
it doesn't have a subroutine and you just hit him anyway. Capital X, capital D, indeed.
Yeah.
Click. There we go.
I'm okay. The degree to which I'm okay with that, it's high.
Yeah.
Of course, the first card he picks is the Ash.
Oh, and he sees the Archer. Okay.
No, he doesn't see the Archer. I got it out of the hand.
Oh yeah, you're right. Yeah, you got it down. This is fine then. He didn't see the tag punishment that you're holding.
Yeah.
Which is good.
And now he's got less money than us. Not that that won't be fixed in a couple of turns.
Right, but this is the turn that we want to get something on the table. I think a click one draw is a possibility.
I put down the other Jackson. I drew 2 cards. We have an NAPD. It's going down in the remote.
Install advance.
Nah, can't advance it. Don't have enough clicks.
Yeah, you should have click one drew instead of putting the Jackson down because you could top deck an agenda, still put it down and put the Ash behind it last click.
But
against the NAPD.
Hindsight's 20/20.
But it is. Your fingers are faster than my Skype connection.
Game day.
Oh man. Sweeps is looking good.
Yeah, if he puts down the beach party, I'm gonna be so excited. It's gonna make that sweeps week super good. Oh my god, is he not gonna run it? I'm gonna get to put the Ash in on top of that NAPD if he doesn't run it this turn.
Yeah.
Yep, he's not running it. All right.
Memory.
So I guess okay. So I'm not gonna go too fast this time.
All right. Yeah,
I'm gonna put down the Ash. Okay, I'm going to advance the NAPD once.
Right. And then you're holding a sweep still when your card is cut off by your cat's face on Skype. Or maybe that's me. Oops. There, that's better. I figured it out.
So I'm going to put the Ash down.
Yeah.
I'm going to advance the NAPD.
Right.
And my question to you is, do we put the wraparound in front of the Archer?
If anything...
Do we put the Data Raven in front of it?
If anything, you put the Data Raven in front of it so that they can't switchblade both, but that will completely bankrupt you and leave you nothing for Ash. So I think that you...
But
just,
do we care?
Credit. Yeah, I mean, I think you take a credit. If you fall behind, one take eight turn, we'll have you clawing back the rest of the game, especially with stealth.
That's true.
You gotta just make him go now. And he probably just won't. but he didn't see the midseason or the closed accounts. But yeah, like stealth players, they're primarily concerned with just building their rig and trying to win before you get an Astro. Next level play would be if that is an Astro.
What, bluff does an NAPD?
Yeah, exactly.
It's like when I kill people with Fetals in RP by bluffing them as NAPDs.
Yep, and they stim hack into it. Awkward.
All right.
We're going in.
All right, so we're going to go ahead. Do I even res it? I guess I have to now that I've selected it.
You don't have to. Because, I mean, you've got the Ashtrace, and you can win the Ashtrace with you making news credits.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, he's got no link.
Right. You just have to, like, bump it up to 6, and, like, there you go. Now we lose the Ash over this, but that Archer would do nothing but just eat a cloak, you know, credit, then I think it's better this way.
Now, he's still going to just be able to come back in and get the NAPD, but then we're going to mid-season the crap out of him.
Yeah, exactly.
And we can get rid of that personal workshop.
Yep.
Oh, please go in. Are you keeping an eye on the comments?
Oh, yeah. I am managing many windows right now. The stream is just not loading for me.
Can you see the comments, though?
Yeah, I can see the comments. Hold on. Beep boop. Yeah, I can see the comments. Just no stream.
That's weird.
It just says loading video. I see gray live.
Hang on. I can still see it.
Okay.
So it must just be you. You might not have the proper plug-in on that computer or something.
I saw it earlier, but I'm just not seeing it now.
He decided not to run it. So what do we do now? Do we score it out or do we leave it?
Oh, let's see.
I think
our credits compared to their credits.
I think I green level advance it one time.
I think to advance it anymore is not going to be effective because we don't really want to score it, but I mean, we are already at 1 point. That'll put us at 3 points. If we don't make them run, then we need to just win.
Okay, so
NAPD is our best shot for landing a midseason, but if our only tag punishment card right now is closed accounts and we're going against a stealth deck that doesn't need credits, I think we might just want to start racing the clock on this. The runner has shown that they don't trust us. They're not really interested in playing games.
All right, so we have to pitch something.
Yeah.
What do we pitch? I think we pitch the Data Raven since they're already...
I think so, too. Yeah.
They're kind of gun-shy anyway.
If we get an information overload, then we can go back to trying to get a midseason to land. Because we can stack that with an Archer until they find enough stealth credits. Or we could just get a Shoot the Moon, and then it's just free, and that's good, too. Oh, did I hit pop out? I better look. He makes a good point. Let's see.
Alright, he's saying just give me the damn tag.
Yeah, he's just going in.
Nada. Whenever somebody takes a Data Raven tag and doesn't pull anything...
Yeah. Because look, that run cost him 3 clicks. Like, there was the run, the Opus, and then the tag clear. That was a 3-click top deck. It was grossly inefficient.
So let's play green level. Let's get some more money.
Definitely.
We got a Beal. I think we play the binary ice game, and I put down the Beal... put the wraparound on our scoring server and see what happens.
Yeah, yeah, put down the wraparound, put down the Beal for sure, because there's no clone chip, there's no SMC.
Yeah, so I think we just, we play the do you have the...
Right, we
do you
the gear check.
Yeah, do you have the breaker game.
Let's see. And he's got 24 cards left in his stack. Okay.
Oh.
Yeah, there's the clone chip in the SMC. Bringing the mem chip off. 7. 7 memory, huh? Guess that's what happens when you have a bunch of mem chips.
I can't imagine.
See, do all that setup and then Opus and then run. Now, yeah, just res it for the sake of making him go and get it.
Yep.
And then when he takes it, then we get into midseason town. So that's 2 credits there.
Oh, at least it's the most expensive one it could possibly be.
Right. Now we just let that archer just sit there. Okay, take it. You have 1 credit and no clips.
Yeah, the degree to which I'm okay with that is high. Yeah, you can have that, man.
Help yourself. You earned it, buddy.
Yeah. Oh my god, and I just pulled a hedge fund. Oh, the gods are just. All right, yes. So I think I just hedge fund mid-season, used my 2 trace. The real question is, how much do we add to this?
It depends. Do you have a sweeps week in hand?
I do.
I'm going to flop back here. Let's see. You played a hedge fund. You're holding mid-season closed accounts.
I think I could just do base trace and add 2 to it. Because he's still going to get a minimum of 7 tags.
Right, that's a minimum 7 tags with Opus that basically if you give them more than 4, they'll tend to go tag me.
Right, so let's just do that.
Yeah.
That seems good.
And now last click, you need to put a binary ice
on
R&D to stomp the onslaught.
Okay.
It's going to go nuts.
Put that wraparound on now.
Yeah, that way we're at least burning lady counters, and then the clone ship is going to be doing double duty on the remote.
Yeah, I agree.
All right, hey, I got the stream working again. Just had to close the window and open it back up.
Pretty good. All right, so we got a toll booth now. I'm going to Jackson click 1, see if we can draw a money card.
Yeah. Or any of our punishment cards. A psycho would be nice. 2 closed accounts. Just hold the closed accounts for every time they take 8.
I'm going to put an ash into the remote, bluff it like an astroscript. See if he'll burn up some lady counters.
Yeah.
And the good news is
he's got 2 cloaks and a silencer.
So he can get through Archer. Right now he can get through Archer 1 time.
Right. But a Tollbooth Archer server he can't get into right now without another Ghost Runner, which we can kill because he's tagged.
Right.
So hey. I think with the Ash on top of that, definitely getting a Tollbooth into that remote and then affording it is what our plan should be.
Yeah, another really nice thing is that his personal workshop is basically dead.
Right.
Oh my god, he just clicked up to max money, and then, sure gambled.
This is nice.
So I guess if I had to, I'm just gonna go ahead and...
So I guess this...
I guess that's gonna happen now.
And then the sweeps,
And then, I'm gonna...
We got an agenda to put in there yet? What are you
no,
holding?
I'm drawing with Jackson.
Ooh, alright. Jackson, draw last click. That's dangerous.
Yeah. You know how disheartening that must have been for him to just have that money and just gone? The best part is we can just do it again.
Yeah, because he's going to... There, okay. There's so many installable cards in this deck. Can you imagine connecting with an information overload right now? And that's what I'm saying.
That's the dream. All right, so we've got some ice that could be put down. I think I'm going to put one of these TMIs on the scoring remote.
TMI, that's pretty taxing, too, for Lady. That's not a trace that he's going to want to pay for.
We'll hedge. Do we sweeps when he's at 4 cards?
No, hold the sweeps.
And then I'm going to just click for a credit then.
Yeah, we can afford to wait. We want to hold that sweeps for after dumping all of our credits into an ashtrays when we're trying to get an astro. And we basically just wait for a psycho or an archive memories. Just keep him poor. Yeah, 0 hour is right. We are actually playing Shoot the Moon, so avoiding that scoring remote as long as possible until all the ice is in place is probably a choice play.
He keeps leg working when it should be the right thing to do, but we just happen to not have anything.
Right. And he's not seeing the other closed accounts, which is awesome.
Yeah. That's also pretty good.
And he is at 0 credits.
Gonna go ahead and just put that Beal in.
Yeah. And just double advance it.
Yeah, and just go ahead and do that.
Because you can.
Yeah, just go ahead and windmill that into
and then top deck a Psycho and win the game. Problem solved.
That would be pretty rad. Alright, we're gonna res this here wraparound, make you burn up some lady counters.
Yep. And then the TMI wraparound on the remote's gonna be pretty good from there. And then he top decks an Astro. We're like, well,
I mean, that's okay. I guess he's not breaking the trace, so.
Right, I mean, those stealth credits don't grow on trees.
Oh no, apparently he is breaking it, so. Boo.
Boo.
I mean, he still doesn't have the money to get into this server.
And that's a 3-point Beal now. That's pretty nice.
And we got an NAPD.
So, yeah, your next play after scoring out this Beal is going to be close accounts, NAPD advance, basically. And then if he takes it, whatever. He's at 6, and he's still broke.
Yeah.
With personal workshop, I would expect a stim hack. But he's just real determined to just get in there. Oof. It's getting scary.
Yeah.
He has a 2 credits, though. So, you can put the NAPD in there, and you can res the Ash and the Archer. I mean, you're poor, but, like, you could do that, because we're sitting at 6 points. We could afford to lose that breaking news.
Okay, so I'm going to sweep, install the NAPD, and then advance it once.
Exactly.
And then we just got to basically hope he doesn't top deck an agenda.
Yep. And the odds are fair on that, I will say. There's 15 cards left in your deck, so you got 1/3 of your deck. And there's 2 Astros, 1 Breaking News, 1 NAPD in there. So four agendas, any of them top decked. He's accessing 2 cards, so it's about a 40% chance that he wins. Unless he hits the NAPD. But now he's stealth, so still. Yeah, about a 40% chance. I would wait till he runs, and I would Jackson in, like, 3 trash cards.
Yep.
Definitely dilute it. That'll put you down to about 30.
Did we go down to 1 Psycho?
I
think we still have 2.
Yeah, I think 2 is what you want to have.
All right, let's see.
Oh, if we don't acknowledge successful run. Use that Jackson. Womp womp.
Womp womp.
Doing those fast F3s.
So, how did we feel about it so far?
Overall, felt pretty good. A little bit janky, you know, like kind of haphazard. It was nice to have so much money. Yeah, he never knew what we spent the influence on.
Yeah, he didn't see very much of it.
Right.
I think one of the issues is that since we're not killing, we're not finishing the game fast enough.
Yeah, I was just thinking, even though you were getting legwork to heck and back, that a fast track or two, or maybe just one, a way to get an agenda when you have a scoring window, any big remote deck loves that idea, whether it be through Daily Business Show or what have you.
Yeah.
Business Show just breaks R&D lock, and so what we really need to figure out is how we guard R&D once we make them go tag me.
Yeah.
I think a larger concentration of mid-grade ice is one place to start, but then we need to pump our money. Because either we afford the mid-season and we connect with that and then we shoot the moon these larger ice, or we aren't able to connect with the mid-season and we're able to use our money to res this taxing ice to buy us time.
Right.
That's the way I see it.
All right, let's try to get another game before we make any changes. But the waiting.
Yeah, it felt like it was very much, oh, we landed the midseason. Okay, so now what?
Right.
I drew this. Okay, good. Oh, hey, he's rich. So this ended up being good to have in our hand. Like that kind of a feeling.
Yeah, I also feel like there is a fundamental thing where tag decks are better against people who aren't running Mopus because we can destroy their ability to recover, right?
Yeah, but Mopus is so click intensive. I mean, you saw even with the stealth, like he was just broken, staying broke.
All right, we've got another person. Let's rock it out.
Yeah, 0 hour. I've been reading on StimHack about some of those ideas as well, about running a tag light deck, one that doesn't play mid-season, but instead has enough taxing ice that you're able to kind of keep one or two tags at a time and use them as a springboard for your fast advance tricks, and that there's only a couple of tag punishment cards in. It seems like a good idea. I haven't had the time to pursue it because regionals is in like 2 days.
This guy listened to me on San San South.
Oh, I gotta join this game.
Well, this should be interesting. All right, so I think this is definitely a keeper for an opening hand.
Oh, yeah, this is a keep any hand with tag punishment because you go and get siphoned.
Yeah, I think we put the TMI on HQ. The Gutenberg.
I put the Viper on HQ, don't you think? The one that is going to end the run?
I mean, doesn't TMI end the run?
I guess if you win the trace, yeah.
Yeah, I can see that.
And then, yeah, that's true. I mean, he doesn't have a link. Once it's res, it's a 5-strength barrier, which is obnoxious.
Yeah, no, Viper's probably a good call. We'll do that. Alright, so let's go ahead. Oh my god, and the first draw of the game is a mid-season replacement. The world is good.
Yeah, then we can have the TMI for archives to answer the sneak door.
Yeah, that's pretty good. It's pretty not bad.
Oh, Mr. Lee.
Yeah. I always love when a runner's first click isn't a sure gamble and they play like a resource that just eats up more of their clicks.
Yeah, they play a crap, I need something other than what I have card.
Alright, so let's go ahead and let's get rid of your last remaining click.
Let's just go ahead and take that click. That's a Lumberg GIF right there. Yeah. I'm just gonna take that click.
And you're also not gonna get in. And I don't have to boost the trace. Login rejected. Yeah, that's pretty good.
That's how we do that.
That's how we do that. he's pretty broke. Do I
without another tag punishment card in hand, yeah, it wouldn't serve anything except just right. Make him tagged.
I'm just gonna do this. I'm gonna put the TMI on archives.
Yeah. And then maybe drop Jackson and Jackson up or discredit credit.
Yeah, let's just Jackson up. Let's see what we draw. He's not able to really threaten HQ yet, because even if he puts a passport or something down, he's not getting in.
Right. I mean, it's still a 4-strength 2-sub Kogate, so.
I never I always forget how just brutal Viper is to anyone who has zero base leg.
Yeah.
Oh, man, this Gutenberg res.
Yeah, 2 clicks and 2 credits. This is a good res. Because that means that's his last click and that's him going to zero, or it's him losing Mr. Lee after he didn't sure gamble when the game opened. That's going to be a big hit, so he'll have to clear.
I'm starting to develop a love of yellow cards, Kyle.
I'm telling you, it's pretty great. You know, I see it as a control deck. I see yellow as the control.
Right, because you can basically herd your opponent into doing what you want them to do.
Yeah, and it's a lot less fast and loose than a butcher shop or any kind of a Waylon, because I'm a big Waylon advocate, you know. And
right. Well, you have
Waylon is all about, you know, getting to the edge of the event horizon of Scorch without ever fully committing, because if you commit and they Plascreet, you lose.
Right. All right, so I've got one click left. Draw one card.
Let's see. Well, we got the troll. He's got one credit, so it's not like we worry about losing Jackson. So, I'd say go ahead and draw a card on that. Yeah, as long as we're holding the midseason.
Oh, there look at that. Yeah, that's pretty good.
Yeah, so now we just want to get a bunch of credits and find a Beal, basically.
Yeah, because we're...
Before he finds a breaker, because he's going to do it soon.
Yeah, but I would say this is us. Like, as somebody who played Gabe a lot, this is super suboptimal for him. He wasn't able to apply early pressure and get that early money lead that Gabe needs. So his ability. Oh, Jesus. All right.
Looking pretty good here. So this is where we just put that breaking news down and we say, you're going to lose Mr. Lee or you're going to take this.
So do I just put it down and advance it, and leave it on the table?
Install advanced credit.
Yeah.
Because that's also an NAPD bluff. And then if he doesn't take it, he loses to Mr. Lee, which would be pretty decent.
Yeah, it's pretty okay.
The more he has to click, you know, we're taxing his clicks. That's really what tags are about at their essence. Regardless of what econ you're playing, is that they tax your clicks. And yeah, if he has to manually draw, that's going to put us further ahead, just in terms of work compression.
I agree. Bank job.
Oh, here we go. I like this play. He's going to bank job, and then... Unfortunately, it's not an NAPD, because if it was, I'd still be okay with this. Because now we need the top deck of Hedgera Sweeps.
I don't think he's going to run it.
Oh, yeah, I'm seeing a really good point in the stream that putting a Draco in
maybe
a solid idea.
He's not going to run it, so he's still losing Mr. Lee.
Yeah.
Because he thought that it was NAPD. Last click, gain a credit.
Yep.
What do we pitch?
I would toss Data Raven because we've got the midseason.
Yep.
Information Overload and midseason and Psycho. Like, you have all of the cards you need for this game in your hand. You just need to not lose them. I wonder if this is going to be like some kind of Spanish influenza style game.
There
like
it is.
My buddy Snake Eyes plays with the Cyber Feeder.
Oh, you know what the best part is?
The traces again.
If I want the barrier to stick, I do have to increase it by. I have to pay one actual credit.
Yeah. I would pay one actual credit. I mean, it keeps it up.
Yep.
But then there's the option of just putting the two into it and then making him spend all of his credits to deny you three credits.
Nah, I just. I want to make sure we keep that Beal.
I think you're right.
Yeah.
Plus, I forgot he's going to get his two credits off that sneak door run, so that was the right call.
Yeah. Because now he has three pieces of ice on all three centrals that he really has no answer for.
Right. His only option is to find some burst decon or find a decoder and a siphon, which would be pretty nasty because he's got a same one on the table already. Or if he's playing in makers or indexing, then he can just walk through the Gutenberg when he wants to.
So we pulled an Archived Memories.
Okay. So Psycho is still looking great here. But we just need to connect with that midseason. We don't really have the credits to do it.
Yeah.
Might be time to Jackson dig. Maybe lose the Beal for now. Because our hand's going to get too full of combo cards.
Do we go cheeky and install the NAPD and see if he runs it and loses the money? Nah.
No, not with that bank job.
All right, so let's click for two creds. I'm going to pitch the Beal for now. I don't think we need the troll.
Yeah, pitch the troll and keep one NAPD for the midseason bait.
Yep. Well, if he actually spends all the money to get into archives, I'll actually leave the NAPD, depending on how much money he has left.
Yeah, that's true. I mean, he is effectively locked out right now, unless he wants to go tag me.
Data sucker, you say?
Maybe a parasite game, like what Timmy was playing the Worlds?
Maybe. I mean, that would make sense with the Cyber Feeders.
Yeah. I was looking for that or Lamprey initially.
The best part is it still costs him four credits to get past Gutenberg with Fairy.
Yeah.
It's pretty
six
good.
Strength. Yeah, you put a sub boost on Gutenberg, it gets pretty gross pretty quick, by the way. Just want to drop that.
Yeah.
I'm having so much fun with sub boost lately.
Yeah, the problem that I'm having with all these yellow decks is there's too much that I want to include.
Yeah.
I need to get something out of my hand.
Yeah, you see, this is the problem with these combo decks. Like, we have five cards that are like, hey, you better not get tagged. And he's like, okay, I won't. And you're like, good, because I don't want to draw anything.
Can we put Information Overload in a remote? Like, is that a thing?
Oh, absolutely, yeah.
All right, so let's get that out onto the table, then I'm just going to click for two credits. Because he doesn't have any way to... I'm guessing his money is resource-based.
Yeah, I would expect bank job, siphon, probably not Katie, because Gabe doesn't really have time for Katie. I'm surprised I haven't seen a special order, or like a sure gamble, or, you know, anything yet.
I want to know what his decoder is. Like, criminals, like, how useful your code gates are going to be can be told by whether or not they're running Zool or something else. Because when a criminal puts down Zool, I get very happy because I'm going to be able to tax them a lot.
Yeah. Yeah, this is definitely like the season of Gordian Blade if you're going to be a criminal. Code gates are everywhere. All right. Well, we've already got a Jackson on the board.
So I think I'm going to actually put the NAPD down, advance it once.
Yeah.
And then if he goes for it, I can archive memories for a money card and then mid-season him next turn.
Okay, yeah, that's a fair play. He's up to 7 credits.
I don't see him bursting up to too much more. You know what I'm saying?
Right. He hasn't played a sure gamble yet, which means he's at 2/3 of the way, or 1/3 of the way through his deck. Inside job.
I'm classic. The degree to which I'm okay with that is high.
Yeah. Tip for you criminal players out there, when you have a fairy on the table,
don't inside
job a remote. Like, make them spend the money.
Ooh, he's...
all you did was spend 2 more credits to take a 4 credit agenda.
Alright, so we're gonna archive memories. Is he at 5 cards? He is. We're gonna get sweeps.
5 cards.
We're gonna get sweep.
And wait for the Beal.
And then we're gonna mid-season replacement. So we wanna get him to that magic 7 tags. So the trace starts at what, 6?
Yeah, base 6.
So let's go up by a total of 4.
Yeah, good. You're leaving yourself at 5, which is smart to get your hedges back.
Yep. And he just let it go, so...
That's what they do, yeah.
Now we're in Tag Me Land. Next turn, my first play is putting the Viper in front of the Gutenberg. Oh my god.
Ha!
Oh, wait, we don't have 6 credits. Damn it.
Oh, man, if you had just put one less credit on that, I forgot to tell you, always afford the information overload.
I was about to say, the world is just.
He does have the fairy, but...
But I could just the upshot is I could just close the counts him next turn.
And then put something in there and be like, come over here and get this. He doesn't really have anything to lose, though, is the thing. Like, I would like for him to have a breaker.
I mean, he's Gabe. I've won games with Gabe with, like, at the end of the game, I had a sneak door down. Like. I can't wait to close the counts, him.
I'm gonna wreck those bank accounts.
Dude.
Oh, yeah, especially now. Yeah, I mean, he has no reason. I guess he intends to pay all the way through the trace?
Yep.
So this is great.
Oh, wait. I did the first one by accident. Yeah, if he wants to pay 5 credits just to steal 3 credits on the last click.
Yeah.
Just so I can close the counts him next turn.
Yeah, spending 2 credits there. Spending two there is good. Because 3 is kind of like, do I even want to like siphon right now off of this? Do I want to spend 5?
Oh, yeah. Come on in.
Yep, come and get it. You earned it. Now, we need a sweeps week. Yep, credit. Closed accounts. Credit.
Yeah,
we're both poor.
I hear that closed accounts is a pretty good card against criminals.
It is.
You haven't seen that many money cards.
No, and you got 28 cards left. And you have a second Jackson that we can always just use to inject money cards into the deck. Which might not be a bad idea. I mean, we have a lead right now. He's got 12 tags and he's broke. We really just want to, like, recklessly push ahead. All right, we've got 11 viewers. Awesome.
Pretty good. Oh my god. Oh my god, he just sure gambled.
Why you do this?
Yeah. Just...
keep him too poor to use that fairy for the archer.
That's the idea.
Or let's, yeah, man, you just don't have any money. I think it would be okay for him to have money right now. Like, I think it would be better spent to just gain money yourself, because maybe he'll same old siphon you.
I mean, that's cool, I guess. I guess I'll just remove that from the game.
Right. Yeah, on his fourth click, I don't get that.
I'm actually gonna get back, I'm going to leave the NAPD in the trash and get back a green level and a sweeps week.
I would take all the money. Leave the agendas in there. You have another Jackson. And, like, he did it on his fourth pick, so it's like, whatever.
No, but I want to get the Beal.
Oh, yeah, you're right. Yeah, because we're set up and ready to go.
So let's green level, see what we pick. I've got a decent amount of money now, so I'm going to go ahead and do that. Closed accounts him. And then click for credit.
Yep. And then we'll Jackson those closed accounts back in.
Yeah, it's pretty good.
Yeah.
Yeah. Closed accounts is such a huge middle finger to criminal. It's unreal. Like.
Yes. Oh, did I just hear? Yeah, the aggressive take three credits maneuver of the runner.
Yeah, I'm going to bluff this as an agenda and see if I can get him to hit the information overload.
Yeah, and then credit. There we go. So with the data sucker, he can't actually just cruise through that information overload once.
That's fine. And then he's still going to find an ash at the end of it.
This is true.
Yeah, buddy.
Inside job? Nope, no. Just a run. No reason not to res that. Now we got to watch out for emergency shutdown.
He can't get. He can't get
a decoder. Yeah. And the cyber feeder too. You pumped it with news credits. Insult to injury.
I've got to make sure it's got 13 subroutines.
Right. In case he decided to go stealth.
I had, at a tournament, I had a guy, in, against my, making news deck, get hit with a 16-tag, information overload. I was like, if you could just uninstall your entire rig, that'd be great.
Yeah. He didn't, okay. So using the fairy. And yeah, because of the cyber feeder, he has enough to trash the ash.
That's okay. It's not the end of the world. He's still broke, which is still great for us.
But if we wipe his rig, then we can't, you know, that's still not a scoring remote for us without something porous.
Yeah. If only I had...
Time to dig. What we need is money.
That looks pretty good.
Oh, yeah. Oh, the shoot the moon? Yeah, time to just put all that ice down. Let's just do this.
I think we put the Archer on the remote and the Viper on R&D and then go to town.
I was going to say, he should just be top decking. Like, every turn, he should be running through and top decking. And there you go.
Okay.
Power of the top deck.
Power of the top deck, indeed. All right, here's what I think we do.
I think the Viper should go on the remote because you can ferry through Archer, walk through information overload if you need to. Yeah, that looks better.
And then we'll just click for a credit and then next turn we'll hit shoot the moon.
Yeah. And you can even, if you draw a piece of ice, you can even install that ice first click too, which is pretty cool. He'll be able to siphon you with a passport his next turn with the credits that he's at right now.
Okay. That's a risk we're going to have to take. We don't have a choice.
Oh, just kidding. Because that. I forgot we were doing that.
Yeah, it's pretty good.
Kind of hitting a dry spell of agendas.
Yeah. This is always my luck.
Credit up to 5. He's thinking about doing that short gamble. Oh, he does it. Okay.
There we go. All right, so just start clicking for money to get ready to win the game.
Yeah, it's a good thing that R&D is well protected. HQ with a decoder is still open. So
before the start of next turn, I'm gonna Jackson Howard and put the closed accounts back in.
Yeah. Or really, burst econ, and maybe one closed accounts because you've got 18 cards left in your deck. You're gonna see some of them pretty shortly. Closed accounts is reactive, but it doesn't, if we get siphoned, we're still at zero, and then he can be broke too, but he's got more clicks than us. And a desperado. So he'll have better recovery.
Ooh. Oh my god.
Ooh, so that happened. Femming the TMI. And now he's back on his Gabe credits. I think you should mid-season him again, just on principle. It's the duty of your deck.
Alright, so we're seeming to have a serious closing issue with this game, with this deck.
Yeah. I think that we'll learn to pilot it better. You know, once they're tagged, it's basically Binary Eyes, Ash, Jackson Dig, and just go.
All right. I think I put the troll on archives.
Let's see. What's his credits? Five credits?
Three credits.
Three credits? Okay. Yeah, the troll's gonna minus one you.
Hang on. Let's go for the gusto.
Yeah, I would say
wrap around
digging right now. Yeah, there you go. That's better.
Another gear check.
And if he's got a parasite, that archer's going to be dead pretty shortly. So you might want to purge next turn. Since we don't have fast advanced tools, we have to take the time to kind of control the board state.
Easy mark. Forge activation orders. Yeah, I'll res it. What are we doing here, man?
Let's see. We are not seeing agendas, and our cards are getting thin. I would have kept the troll, tossed the midseason.
Yeah, that's true.
We got the sweeps, that's good. Basically, we're just waiting on an agenda. Like, as soon as we get any agenda, it's just going to be psychoed out. Have we used our archived yet this game? I'm watching just grab the breaking news here.
Nope. Thank God.
Okay, there. Problem solved. Some things fix themselves. Now we just have to not lose the breaking news in a four-card hand.
You mean a three-card hand, because we're about to use Psycho.
Yeah. Man, putting that Astro down and then scoring out the Beal is the safest thing we can do. Because we know that he can't get it. See, now, drawing helps it a little bit, but when he's at 6 points, you really don't want to take a risk like that. Because we can probably safely assume that that Astro is safe in that remote for one turn. Because now that he's got a rig, like, he doesn't want to run that information overload and lose everything, even if he could get a corroder, or yeah, decoder.
Well, yeah. The other problem is this run is credit neutral for him, so he's just going to keep doing it.
Right. Stacking data suckers until he can Parasite Archer. Getting pretty lucky so far, though.
Now, while he's using Sneak Door, where does the Ash go? Does it still go on HQ? If we want to keep him out of HQ?
If you want to keep him out of HQ, then it has to be...
Because it's treated...
I don't think it works like that, because Ash says you can't access any other cards except Ash, but Sneak Door is access replacement that takes you to HQ.
Yeah. Gonna use all the data suckers and try to...
Yeah, that's kind of Gabe's thing, is gratuitous expenditure to see the top card of R&D. Because he's so built for HQ.
Oh, yeah, he just doesn't even want me to run it, okay.
I think this is probably the nail in the coffin. There's so few cards in your deck.
We live to fight another day.
Oof. Fast and loose. What do we got? Double sweeps. All right, time to draw. Find an agenda and get in that remote. And then probably put the Ash... What's his credits? 2 credits? Put the Ash on R&D. We got a ton of money right now.
I don't think we need this Gutenberg.
I think you're correct. And then you'll go down to 1 credit on the Ash, which is fine, because you can sweeps and you can hedge. As long as you stay credit... Like, you know, low credit enough that Siphon's not a problem... We discard R&D until we find an agenda. He's got to be looking for some kind of burst decon and a decoder right now. For like a, you know, one turn remote crack glory run if we don't find the psycho.
He's probably digging for a fairy, realistically. There's nothing for you, buddy.
That breaking news...
There it is.
...is so elusive. Do you res a breaking news over this when you have one in hand? Can he break it?
I don't have 4 credits.
Oh, you don't. Bum, bum, bum. Alright, well, he earned it.
Yeah, I mean, he still has to break the Ash Trace. Which I can,
Yeah, you can put to 6 if you need to.
No, I can... Yeah.
Oh, no, 7 if you need to. And then he'll trash the Ash, which takes him to 2.
No, it takes him to 3, Desperado.
Oh, yeah.
We're just playing a very dangerous money game here.
Yeah.
All right, let's
DLC. Oh, you know we fire that. There it is. All right. I seriously think that breaking news is a liability and we should just get rid of it as soon as possible. We're just playing like a total numbers game. Oh, you went down to four cards.
Let's see how much longer I can get ridiculously lucky.
I was gonna say, when you're playing a numbers game for this long. Hey, I know the guy that just joined the game. He's from my meta.
This is going to have to be my last game. I have to be up very early for work tomorrow morning.
I worked today so that I wouldn't have to work tomorrow so I can travel to Louisville for regionals. Which started the chain of events that led to me getting home at 8:45 with no internet and having to just cram all my crap in a car and drive to someplace with internet. Guardian Blade, big spender.
Yeah,
I would have really gone for the backup decoder on this one. I mean, Guardian, when you have a data sucker already, unless there's stacked code gates, that's just, at this point in the game, that's pretty expensive.
So to get a Beal victory, we need to put 7 advancements on it, I think.
Yeah, 6 with the Astro.
Yeah, that makes me feel so much better.
Click Siphon. Yeah. With 1 credit to break the ETR. I think he meant to sucker the Viper.
This is so good.
Yeah. You gotta do something next turn or he's gonna same old siphon the bejesus out of you, though.
Okay. So here's what we do. We close the counts. We sweeps weak. And then we put the NAPD in the remote.
Let me think. It takes him 1 credit and 2 clicks to siphon you on his last clicks, which means he can't get into the remote. So yeah, if you close the counts him. Yeah, that's fair. Close the counts. Maybe hold the sweeps and install advance the NAPD. Because if he sweeps, he's definitely going to take your money. Sweeps is really good for siphon recovery. Because he can't first and second click siphon you. Or he'll have to break the other trace on the Viper.
Playing these tag punishment decks just creates these these decks where you're like super duper duper like stressed out.
Yeah.
Because you're basically just trying to race to victory.
Oh, I missed his turn. It happened. Oh, it, no, it hasn't started. Okay. Have you been telling people that they're on the stream?
No. Should I be?
I don't know. I kind of wonder about that. Only because if he's just like, you know, hey, gotta crap, and he's just gone 10 minutes.
Well, see, I think the opposite is true. I think if I tell people that they're on the stream, they're gonna get analysis paralysis.
Yeah. I think that's true. Or if not analysis paralysis, some kind of paralysis. Same old thing, easy mark? Nope. I'm like trying to figure out what is he doing. Same old thing, easy mark, same old thing, siphon.
Yep, he's probably going to win right here.
Ooh, 8 cards new deck. What's still in there?
A lot.
2 deals, 1 astro, 1 oh, NAPD.
He didn't hit anything.
Wow. You need to win, like, immediately. Yeah, I should have thought about you not being able to res the Archer before I told you to install advance that.
What is he doing?
He's trying to do math. But with one click left, he can't break the Viper, right? He has to lose the click. And he has to break the ETR.
Okay, cool. So do you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to just put my money into the trace so he gets no money.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I guess that's a pretty good play, actually. The one that he doesn't break. Because then you can credit sweeps on your turn.
He's got Cyber Feeder.
Right. He doesn't get any credits, at least.
He does get in.
He gets his Gabe money. Can he use that to get in? No. Not without losing everything.